Hi, welcome back to my channel. My name is Laura, and guess what I got in the mail today? Another box from Book Outlet. So, I had a coupon, spend $35, and you get $5 off. So, that's what I did. I have a whole bunch of books here. So, I already pre-cut it open, so I'm going to share what's in here. So, of course, they give you a lot of paper. Okay, lots of paper. Look at all this paper. Jeez. Okay, so what's in this box? The first book I'm going to show you was I looked up on Amazon to see how much this was, and it was like $30-something, and they had it on sale at Book Outlet. I don't remember how much it was, but, oh, wow, it's a fat book. I'm trying to grab it out of here. I got the Outlandish Companion by Diana Gabaldon. So this is a hardcovered book, and this has, I think, all her editions in here, and it tells you, like, the synopsis of each one, so it's like a combined type thing, and this was over $30-something on Amazon, so I'm reading Outlander now. I'm actually on book two, which is, Dragonfly in Amber is book two. I have it over here on the other side. So I want to see what this looks like inside. So first it has a map on the inside. And it's just a purple cover. And this will be nice to go on my collection on the shelf. So, yeah. So that's that. Let's see if there's any pictures in here. I don't know. So, let's see. There's like a picture of, I guess, Scotland. Let me get to page two. Maybe that's the rock that she sat at. I don't know. So that's that there. And there's more maps and different things in here. There's lots of pictures on each page, but they're like drawings. So look, drawings. So. And I know that there is like a synopsis and list of characters, and it's just helped me get through the book more. It's like a dictionary. Look, here's the family tree. So, yeah. And I thought this would be really cool to read alongside or look anything up. It's like a textbook of different things about the books and stuff. So, yeah. So, I got this the first thing I got. Nope, the thing doesn't want to close. Alright, so, big book. So that's the first book. I'll put it over here. Alright, so, the second book that I got in here is to add to my collection as well. And this is another very expensive book, hardcovered. It's purple. I got the Harry Potter, the Creature Vault. So this is the purple edition, very fat book. This look, it says $55.50, and I think I got it for like $10. $55.50, see that? So I got this, I think, like $10 or something like that, hardcover to go on my shelf, Harry Potter. And there are pictures in here. It's like a picture book. Very pretty pictures. And the different creatures in the Harry Potter series. And I thought this was really cool when I saw that on Book Outlet. And, of course, it is my favorite color on the front. It's very nice too, and it's like wedged. What do you call it? It's like bumpy. The front is like bumpy, raised. So yeah, it's just such a pretty book. So this was also on Book Outlet. Look what I got.
What?
This is book. This is Harry Potter. Goes to the Harry Potter series. So look, there's all pictures and stuff of the creatures in the story. Isn't that cool? Mm-hmm. All right. So that's the second book that I got, and that's a very heavy book. Okay. So while I was there, I got one book that was the 50/50 on the 50/50 half price, and I got this one. The Year I Met You by Cecilia Ahern. So, yeah, so I got this on the 50/50, and I think it's a romance book. Let me read the back because I don't really know. Okay, you have never acknowledged my existence, nor are yours, but you are a circus act all of your own, and I cannot help but be your audience. Jasmine loves two things, her sister and her work, and when her work is taken away, she has no idea who she is. Matt loves two things, his family and the booze. Without them, he hits rock bottom. One New Year's Eve, two people's paths collide. Both have time on their hands, both are at a crossroads, but as the year unfolds, through moonlit nights and suburban days, an unlikely friendship slowly starts to blossom. Sometimes you have to stop still in order to move on. So that's this book. Pretty cover, isn't that pretty? So I got this in the 50/50 section. So, okay, so the last two books I have in here are ghost books. I've been thinking about reading ghosts. So, and I saw these on Book Outlet, and I was like, oh, no, because I had to spend $35. The reason I went on is I wanted to get the Harry Potter and the Outlander books. So that's the reason I went on there, but I had to get the $35. So I wound up getting two ghost books. I got The 20th Century Ghosts by Joe Hill, and Joe Hill is Stephen King's son. So, yeah, these are short stories, and I actually had this out from the library, and I was like, oh, and then I saw it on Book Outlet. I said, you know what, I really like Stephen King books, and I loved, I read his one book, Horns, and I liked it. So I figured might as well get it, and I'm on a short story kick, so I picked this one up. And the second one I picked up is a ghost story as well. And it's hard-covered. It's called Ghosts by Roger Clark. It's a natural history, 500 years of searching for proof. And look at that cover. That's pretty cool. And this is also short stories as well in here. I wanted to see what the cover looks like. It's just brown. Just brown. So, I don't normally buy hardcovers, so that's why I'm, like, intrigued to open up to see what's underneath. Yeah, so this is, short stories as well, and I like to, read it and see what's going on. So, those are the five books that I got from Book Outlet. I spent $37.94. So, yeah, but the Harry Potter book and the other book are over $30-something on Amazon. So if you can get them at Book Outlet, it's much cheaper. They are heavy books. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you in another video. Bye. Oh, what is in the middle of this book? Oh, it's so cool. There's owls. And here I am saying, ooh. There's a little thing here with different owls in it. That's pretty cool. Look at that. That's so pretty. Ooh. Look at that. Oh, this is so pretty. I can't wait to sit down and like browse through this thing. That's pretty cool. So, there's just some different facts and stuff about Harry Potter. Pretty neat. Dementia, Fluffy, here's the Fluffy. So little pictures, sorry, I'm doing it. The box was in the way. But pretty neat thing for, there's ghosts and stuff in here. And how they did it, that's pretty neat. Let me see how much it was, and I'll tell you. I have my receipt here. Okay, the Harry Potter book was $11.99, and the Outlander book was $11.99 as well. And they are both over $30 on Amazon. So, yeah, definitely worth it to buy it at Book Outlet. My shipping was $5.49, but I had a $5 coupon, so my shipping was 49 cents. So, yeah, definitely, if you can, get it at Book Outlet. So, I'm really loving this book, Purple. Oh! Okay, I went and looked in the inside of this, and this is the Outlander series, and it says here, it has full synopsises of Outlander, Dragonfly, and Amber, Voyager, and Drums of Autumn. A complete listing of the characters in all four novels, including extensively researched family trees and genealogical notes. Professionally cast horoscopes for Jamie and Claire. That's what's included in this book. And it says U.S. price is $35 in the inside. So, yeah. So I just wanted to share with you what this is all about. Let's see what it says on the back. A comprehensive glossary and punctuation guide in Gaelic terms and usage. A fully explicated this is why I use the audiobook. Gabaldon theory of time travel. Frequently asked questions to the author and her sometimes surprising answers. An annotated bibliography. Tips, personal stories, even a recipe for two. Essays about medicine and magic in the 18th century, researching historical fiction, and more. With the insight, humor, and eye for detail that has made her novels such an outstanding success story, Diane here gives her readers the best gift of all, The Outlandish Companion. Diana holds a bachelor's degree in zoology, a master's degree in marine biology, and a PhD in ecology, none of which has anything whatsoever to do with her novels. She spent a dozen years as a university professor before turning to writing full-time. Diana lives in Scottsdale, Arizona, with her family. So that was pretty cool. And there is a map here, and you can see where the United States is, and then you can see where Scotland and England is. So that is on the back of the book. So this is pretty cool. So maybe I can learn a little bit more. I did read book one, well, I listened to it, and now I'm listening to book two now. So, and I'm really enjoying the TV show, so this will be a nice addition to add and to read along and learn more. So anyway, thank you for watching, and I will see you in another video. Bye.